Good morning, everyone, and how are you doing this beautiful Sunday morning? We want to welcome you to Interfaith Spiritual Center Worldwide. We want you to know wherever you are on your journey of spirit, you are welcome, loved, and accepted. This is a way of life where we honor all paths to God. At this time, I would ask you to please take a deep cleansing breath all the way down to the soles of your feet. We're going to quiet our minds and we're going to prepare ourselves for service.
In this very room, there's quite enough love for one like me. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for one like me. And there's quite enough peace, quite enough power to walk through my every fear. For spirit, one spirit, is in this world. In this world, there's quite enough love for all of us. And in this venue, there's quite enough joy for all of us. And there's quite enough peace, quite enough power to walk throughout every room. Spirit, one spirit, is in this world. In this very room, there's quite enough love for all the world. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for all the world. And there's quite enough peace, quite enough power to walk through our everything. For spirit, one spirit, is in this bed. Is in this bed.
And there is enough love and power in this very room, and I want to let you know that in this moment of time, you are loved and accepted.
Give me one moment in time. Oh yes, we will be. We will be free. Oh, you're a winner for a lifetime. When you live each moment in time, let it shine. Give us one moment in time when I know where all we could be. Oh, why then, in that one moment in time, I will be. Oh, yes, we will be. We will be free. Oh, we will.
Everyone, once again, I want to welcome you to Interfaith Spiritual Center worldwide. Wherever you are on your journey of spirit, you are welcome, loved, and accepted. You know, our mission here is to heal, inspire, empower, and prosper the world through love, prayer, meditation, and by sharing the principles and applications of successful living. Now, I would like to know if anyone has a prayer request, please put it in our comment right below, and our ministry of prayer will pray over it for 30 days because we do know affirmative prayer does change things. Now, you know, we are in the month of March, and our theme for this month has been invisible acts of power. Our affirmation, I will state it and then repeat it with me afterwards. I embrace life, knowing that every day, in every way, I grow and unfold in miraculous ways. Please join me.
I embrace life, knowing that every day, in every way, I grow and unfold in a miraculous way. And so it is.
Beautiful. Thank you so much. And thank you for your kind attention. And now at this time, I would like to bring Reverend Perry up, who has a few words for you. Thank you.
Greetings. Just take a deep breath with me. We're gathered here today, virtually, to remind ourselves of who we are and what we believe. First and foremost, we know that we are spiritual beings having a human experience, connected to God, to each other, and to all things. We also know that for every challenge, there is a solution, and that solution rests in God. In this age, or the age of this pandemic, we must remind each other to embrace faith over fear, embrace calm over anxiety, and science over superstition. We also evoke compassion and mercy for those who are impacted and suffering. And we affirm wisdom and grace for those who embrace and surrender to the divine. We model for ourselves and for each other the best practices to keep ourselves safe. And we also forgive ourselves and each other for any missteps or careless behaviors that block our best intentions. I want to take a moment to acknowledge the good that has emerged from this pandemic, particularly in our community. Some members and friends are feeding the sick and shut-in, while others are sewing surgical masks for nurses and doctors at hospitals and nursing homes. I affirm with the sages of the ages that we know that God is our shelter in times of storm, and that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Today, during this time of reflection, we affirm the prayer of St. Francis of Assisi. In the midst of this pandemic, let us pray that prayer now. And it simply says, Lord, make me an instrument of thy peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. We pray this prayer in your many names. And so it is.
And so it is.
Amen.
Thank you so much, Reverend Perry. And now at this time, I would like to bring up Dr. Sharron Stroud. Let's get your microphone. We're going to do our meditation at this time. So, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Sharron Stroud.
Thank you so much. Greetings, and welcome to Interfaith Spiritual Center Worldwide, where we believe there is a power for good in the universe greater than we are, and we can use it, and we are using it every single moment of our lives, whether we are consciously aware of it or not. This is why I love our way of life. And when someone asked Dr. Ernest Holmes, who was the founder of our Science of Mind movement, in a sentence, what is religious science? He said, the laws of science, the opinions of philosophy, the revelations of religion applied to human need and the aspirations of every living soul. So on this day where we look at a cause and effect relationship, where we lift the energy from dis-ease to health, to a sense of knowing we are divinely connected, as I share this universal prayer with you that I wrote 30 years ago, I wanted it to be all-inclusive. I wanted it to acknowledge that beyond color, race, creed, sexual orientation, or political affiliation, which I added recently, that we are one, that may oneness prevail. So I invite you just to close your eyes, and when we close our eyes, we allow the energy, we close everything out, and we allow that energy to be heart-centered. So please, identify in mind with me as I speak my word. I know at this very moment that there is one life. That life is God's life, and that life is our life right here and right now. We know that within this one life, there are many paths to God. That right now, somewhere in the world, a Jew is saying his prayers, a Hindu is chanting a mantra, and a Buddhist is kneeling at her sacred shrine. Right now, at this very moment, someone is lighting a candle in a cathedral. Someone is making their Hajj toward Mecca, for it is the will of Allah. And yet someone else is lighting a fire in a jungle, repeating an ancient mystical drama. Many, many pathways up the mountaintop, and the view is always the same from the summit. In the dawning of the spiritual sun, for a moment all faiths became as one. The Christian, Buddhist, Muslim, Jew, became as one and somehow knew that mystic voice that calls to me, O yonder, yonder person, I am thee, we are one. In this one life, which is God's life, we seek first that kingdom, and we know that all good things are added unto us. We know that mentally and emotionally we are in perfect peace. Our mind is stayed on thee. That's right. Our mind is stayed on what is life-giving and life-affirming. We build on that. Physically, we know our body is the temple of the living God, of which and through whom which we do such a good work. We know that our God is bigger than any diagnosis, that wherever dis-ease seems to be operating, anywhere on the planet, the presence of God is. Wherever pain seems to be operating on the planet, the presence of God is. Wherever upset seems to be operating, the presence of God is. And wherever death shows its face, we know that there is the eternal resurrection I am the resurrection and the life. No man, woman comes to the Father, Mother, God, except by right of their own Christ consciousness. What is death but the impatient gesture of the soul to rid itself of a body it no longer needs? And so on this day, as we acknowledge this one life, which is God's life, which is our life, we open to this healing power, this energy. And we affirm this, and even little Minnie affirmed this morning. So let's just breathe deeply and acknowledge our oneness. So as we breathe deeply all the way down to the soles of our feet, we remember what the psalmist told us so long ago. With all you're getting, get understanding. Get a sense of who and what you are. With all you're getting, open yourself and acknowledge a church is not a building. A church is you.
Yes.
Churches don't close. We remain open. And so on this day, we open to the truth that sets us free to be who and what we are. Thank you, Father, Mother, God, for this way of life and for the opportunity to be in the world, but of a higher vibratory frequency. For this we do give thanks. And so it is. Amen. So much for joining me in our morning meditation. Flea has planned something so beautiful for you, and we're just so blessed to have our Flea with us. And what he does many times, if the words don't quite fit the energy in which we live and move and have our being, he makes a little shift with the words, because we know that which we utter becomes the outer, that this is the power center. Decree a thing and it is established unto thee, and he is so consciously aware of that, and I just love that about our Prince Fleet Easton, the Crown Prince of Palm Springs. Aren't we blessed to have his energy? Yes, and I just loved what Reverend Perry said this morning and shared that gorgeous, my favorite prayer is the prayer of St. Francis of Assisi. And I was in Assisi a couple of years ago, and it was so beautiful. You could feel that energy of peace. And I love that you shared that with us this morning. Thank you so much. And we love him too. Yeah, someone said, I love him, you know, on the comments. And we love him too. So are you ready, Fleet?
I'm ready.
Okay, Fleet is ready and raring to go. I present Prince Fleet Easton, the Prince of Palm Springs.
Turning stones to bread, and so
All we need is a helping hand. For we are the world. We are the children. We are the ones to make a brighter day. So let's start giving. There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. It's to make a better day, just you and I. When you're down and out and seems no hope at all, but if you just believe, no way we can fall. Well, let us realize that a change can only come when we stand together all as one. Oh, we are the world, we are the children. We are the ones to make a brighter day, so let's start giving. There's a choice we're making, oh, we're saving our own lives. It's true, make a better day, just you and I. We are the world, oh, we are the children. We are the ones to make a brighter day, so let's start giving. Why, there's a choice we're making, you know we're saving our own lives. It's true, make a better day, just you and I. We are the world. To make a brighter day, so let's start giving. Why, there's a choice we're making, oh, we're saving our own lives. It's true, make a better day, just you and I. And now, ladies and gentlemen, once again, allow me to bring back to our platform here, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Sharron Stroud.
And once again, I greet you, not quite as the world greets you, but with profound esteem, that we are joined here virtually. And I really want to bless energetically the entire Facebook community that has allowed us to come together in this amazing media and medium so that we can put forth our message, because our purpose is to serve, to know God, love God, and serve God through each other. Because you are as close to God as I am ever going to get, and I am as close to God as you are ever going to get. And if I am in that place in me and you are in that place in you, there is only one of us. And when I presented in India a couple years ago, it was amazing. I was speaking to 10,000 people. And when I said namaste, and to have a whole energy field of 10,000 people respond namaste, it was tear evoking. Because we could feel that there was an energy, it was palpable. It was, I'm totally and completely saluting that divinity within you that moves beyond color, race, creed, sexual orientation, and political affiliation. I am saluting the energy that moves beyond churchianity and religion. I am saluting that place where we meet together as one. We are the world. We are the children. We are the ones to make a better day, so let's start giving. And as we give from that place within us that has never known grief, it has never been hurt, it has never been felt offended or given offense. It is the place of peace, the peace that passes all understanding, the peace of God. With all you're getting, get understanding, the psalmist tells us. And that understanding is to see through the appearances, the conditions, and the effects of life that show up. When we see through them, there is the face of God. Walt Whitman said it best, in the faces of men and women, I see God. And this moves beyond religion, color, race, creed. It moves beyond all of it, where we connect at our oneness. And as Reverend Perry said so beautifully this morning, let me be an instrument of thy peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. That to give the benefit of the doubt, because really people don't do things to us. It feels like they do things to us. We tell the story of what they did. We get a lot of sympathetic vibration, don't we? Wow, you poor thing. Don't ever poor thing me, please, ever. You know, that does not serve us. But what serves us is for someone to say, ha, he drew a circle that shut me out. Heretic, rebel, a thing to flout. But love and I had the wit to win. We drew a circle that took him in. We drew the larger circle. And when we are about drawing the larger circle, as we are about moving beyond what has been demonstrated in our lives, as we are about opening the space to allow God to do what God does best by means of each and every one of us, that's the space of miracles. I heard an amazing story about a physician, and he said that he woke up one morning and there was a nodule underneath his arm. Now, I know about nodules underneath arms because my late husband, Neil Stroud, woke up one morning and there was a nodule underneath his arm. And it was Hodgkin's disease. And in that day, there was not a so-called cure, even though he went on for 7 years, 5 amazing, really good years, and 2 years of great challenge on chemotherapy. And these are the days that chemo was really hard and difficult to take. And he said he woke up with this nodule, and he was a physician. He kind of had a sense of what it could be, the C word. And he said as he went along, there was another nodule that showed up on the other side of his arm, which I'm also very familiar with. And it went on. It went into his jaw. So he went and had it diagnosed, and it was mantle cell lymphoma. There is no cure for mantle cell lymphoma. He said, I am a physician. They basically told me, my colleagues, my doctor friends, my physician friends, basically told me, you know, get your house in order and live the best life that you possibly can. And his name was Tom, Dr. Tom Rowan. And he said, I went home and I prayed. And then I called my minister. They started a prayer chain. They had me come in to the church. Now we know that a church is not a building. Churches don't close. Buildings do. We are the church. We remain open. I want to make that very, very clear. So he said they went to their church, and almost everyone in the congregation came to pray with him and for him. And he said he had gone through this for months, and his body was distorted with these incredible tumors. And what happened was, as he sat there, he said, I heard the voice of God. Now, we can call it anything we like. We can call it God, Yahweh, Christ, Krishna, Father, Mother. For him, Dr. Tom Fa, he heard the voice of God, and that said, now go to the doctor. So he went to his physician friend. He said, I'm going to just put you on some chemotherapy. And we know that chemotherapy doesn't heal, but it does extend. And he said, in all those months that he had not even, you know, after the first time when they said, go get your house in order, he had not allowed himself to even go to see his physician. But he said, I heard the voice of God, go to the doctor. He said, I went to the doctor, I went to my friend, my physician friend, and he said, I'm going to put you on chemotherapy. And he said, he put him on chemotherapy, and he said, all of the tumors, over 50 tumors in his body, started dissolving. They started getting mushy like sponges, he said. And he said, after a few days, the tumors were gone. He said, the entire congregation, the minister prayed over me. Now, we know that prayer is one of the strongest healing energies in the universe, and it does move beyond religion. Prayer is universal. Prayer allows us to see through what's being expressed, not buy into it acknowledge it. It's a fact. It's a fact that there's coronavirus on the planet. It's a fact. We know it. In fact, one of my dearest Facebook friends, her mother, is going through this in a nursing home in Canada. So we know it's a fact. And that for every tear that falls into the river of compassion, the energy, you know, that energy that we feel one for the other, that going through pain and upset and going through the appearance of death, we have compassion. We're not saying it's not going on, but we are saying it is not a spiritual reality. And that when we look a discordant fact in the face and we say, you have no power over me, I am all powerful in my life because I am connected to the power of the universe. What's the difference between conceit and humility? The conceit and confidence is humility. So what sounds like conceit is really, it's confidence and humility to realize I of myself can do nothing. It's the Father within that does the work. It's the energy within that does the work. It's the power of God within that does this work. Lord, make me an instrument of thy peace. Where there is hatred, let me so love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is fear and doubt, let me place faith on the altar of life. We are living in very, very interesting times. We are called upon to know the truth one for another. And I do want you to know I do not relate to the term social distancing. I've put it on Facebook. Most of you have agreed. Not everyone. One person didn't. She said she likes the more precise view. And you know what? Perfect. I'm glad that works for you. What works for me is social mindfulness. When I am socially mindful, I'm giving you space. I'm not distancing you. I'm giving you space. And in giving you space, I'm honoring the energy and the health within you. What did St. Paul say? I wish, dear friend, that you may prosper and be in health, even as your soul does prosper. And it's about our soul growth. It's about the unfoldment of who and what we are. So much going on the world. But we believe in science, not superstition. We believe in cause and effect. And we believe in the power of prayer. So as you post your prayers on our Facebook page this morning, just know that we have a miracle working ministry of prayer that will know the truth with you and for you. And that as we speak our word for you, that all the power in the universe bubbles up to lift you beyond the appearance, the condition, and the effect, and allow us to move through it. And for anyone that's listening here today that possibly cried themselves to sleep last night, I want you to know this word is for you, that we care, that we love you, that you are never alone. And even though people are feeling alone, as they get on Facebook and feel the connection, they're feeling love. They're feeling people caring and reaching out beyond the reach of hands, yet ever in the heart. Ever in the heart. So with this physician, that Dr. Tom, that had his community pray for him and his minister, and had one session of chemotherapy, and to have the tumors disappear and return to their native nothingness from whence they came is amazing, because that which needs to be healed is healed, that which needs to be revealed is revealed, that which needs to be known is known, and that which needs to be released is released quickly, gently, and with grace. For eye hath not seen, nor ear heard, neither hath entered into the heart of man and woman the things which God hath prepared for them that love. Love is the strongest healing power in the universe. And if we can love enough, we'll love our way beyond coronavirus, beyond these effects, to the arms of each other. Arms are for hugging, aren't they? So I look forward to that. I definitely look forward to that. And I am socially mindful of the space that it looks like you're over there, but beyond the reach of hands, yet ever in the heart. This is what makes the difference. So on this glorious day, I'm so very grateful that we could be together, that Reverend Perry and our Prince of Palm Springs, that we can serve you right here at the Rose of Sharron Sanctuary, and we can hone the service so that you will know that we care. And as we care, as we allow ourselves to come forth with that loving heart, you will feel it beyond the reach of hands, yet ever in the heart. And I know that we're all going somewhere, and those of you who are part of our community know where it is. Where?
Higher yet.
Where?
Higher yet.
Where?
Higher yet.
Because we are in a high place, and we will not come down. None of these outer things move us. We are in a high place, and we will not come down. And so it is. I say namaste. The divinity within me salutes the divinity within you. I say shalom, the peace that passes all understanding. And God bless us, everyone. And so it is. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you. All right. Lee just got something wonderful prepared for us. And you come right over here. We have our beautiful Kuan Yin that Reverend Linda Orrick gave me. And we, this was a mirror, and it was a little distracting last week. So these were given to me from India, from Dr. Natarajan. So we've put these up as kind of a backdrop, and you can feel that energy. And Lita's going to share Imagine, which is just so beautiful. No one does it quite like Lita, except maybe for the original John Lennon, right?
All the people, yes, sharing.
We are just so very blessed. And if this were a normal service, we would be taking the offering right now. And we are at the Rose of Sharron Sanctuary. There's three of us. Reverend Perry brought these wonderful little hand wipes that we, you know, put on the microphones, and being very, very and completely socially mindful and respecting and honoring each other's space. So as I usually call for the ushers, our wonderful Edie Zavora and Dr. Clayton Beaver usually come up and take the offering. Sometimes Carl Schaefer runs up to take it. And we are not taking an offering because we are not in that situation. So I'm sure that Dr. Roger Bambanek put on the PayPal link if you would like to mail a contribution in to Interfaith Spiritual Center Worldwide. You can do that. I will share our post office box is 2102. It's Palm Springs, California, 92262. That's post office box 2102, 2102, Palm Springs, California, 92262. And Dr. Roger, I'm sure, has placed the PayPal link. I want to really thank those of you. Laura Topper from Brighton, England, has been sending in a tithe every week. I want to really honor you. Dustin Wilson has been sending in his tithe. I want to honor you. I don't usually mention, but I know that it's all right because I posted it on Facebook, and that was all right with you. And those of you who are in compassion with us to keep this message out there, to keep it relevant, and to acknowledge that we are a spiritual community, and that it's really an honor and a privilege to give to something larger than ourselves. And I want you to know, when I started out, I thought, well, if we give to the church, then we're going to take away from something else. And my husband was more evolved than me. I think that's why he left the planet way before me, because I had a lot of learning to do, and I'm still learning, right? And he said, no, we need to create the space, because when you give, you're opening a space to receive. The same opening that I give through is the same opening I receive through. So please, repeat after me. I give this gift with love and joy.
I give this gift with love and joy.
I give this gift as a sacred expression of who I am.
I give this gift as a sacred expression of who I am.
In giving to God, I give to myself.
In giving to God, I give to myself.
I give thanks for the abundance that is mine.
I give thanks for the abundance that is mine.
Beautiful. And then the song that we usually sing is I Am So Blessed. We'll sing a couple, you know, a couple little stanzas of that, so you can get the energy of it. And we are socially mindful. We won't touch each other,
yes,
but we will share the song.
I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful, I am so blessed.
And we will end our service today with Shower the People. We've decided that that is going to be our theme song during this time. So go ahead, please,
right,
as we shower the people with love and perfect.
You can play the game, you can act out the part,
though you know it wasn't written for you. Tell me, how can you stand there with a broken heart, ashamed of playing the fool? You know one thing can lead to another. It doesn't take any sacrifice. Oh, father and mother, sister and brother, if it feels nice, do it twice. Please join me. Just shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Things are gonna work out fine if you only will. What I mean to say is shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Things are gonna be much better if you only will. You know you can. But you can't hide. This is widely known. Tell me, how can you stand there with your foolish pride, afraid of being alone? Oh, when somebody tells you how they feel, you can feel it beginning to ease. I guess it's true what they say about the squeaky wheel always getting the grease. Please join me. Shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Things are gonna be just fine if you only will. What I mean to say is shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Things will be much better if you only will. We have wonderful people going by that we're saying hello to. Hi, how are you? They want to join us. Shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Just shower the people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Shower the you love with love. Show them the way that you feel. Let it rain, oh yeah. Let it rain down low. Show them the way that you feel. Oh, shower the people.
Thank you so much.
With
thank
love,
you.
Sweet love. And Fleet is going to finish us off. You can just acknowledge that we will see you next week. We'll keep you in our prayers, and we are so very grateful for you. Thank you.